as you can tell by my Pikachu t-shirt, I'm going to be doing a new series to do with Pokémon. I've seen a lot of YouTubers do videos on their opinions on every single Pokémon, and that's what I'm planning to do. So yeah, let's get started. Now, I'm going to split this into several videos because I can talk for England. Once I get on a topic, I can talk forever. So I'm going to try and be as brief as I can on each Pokemon, saying what I think about it. Basically each video is going to be about a separate generation of Pokemon, and this one's going to be about Gen 1. The second will be Gen 2, next Gen 3, etc. You know what I mean. A bit of background on my own experience with Gen 1. I own Pokemon Blue, but I haven't played it properly. I only got into Pokemon when I was about 15 or 16, so I'm quite a late. I was quite a late bloomer. So most of my knowledge of the Kanto games comes from Fire Red and Leaf Green, as well as the Let's Go games and Heart Gold and Soul Silver. So apologies if I don't seem to have much knowledge. So let's get started. I've got a list down here of all the Pokemon just to make sure I don't miss any. So if I'm not looking at you, you'll know why. Starting from in Dex order, so starting from Bulbasaur all the way to Mew. Now Bulbasaur I think is really cute and really cool. I especially like it because of Ash's Bulbasaur in the anime, and it's really fun to use on a playthrough when you're trying to like leech seed your enemies and inflict them with all these status conditions. That really, really helps out. And Ivysaur. I really like Ivysaur as well. Ivysaur is kind of cool and cute, but like, looks a bit tougher without losing its cuteness factor, if that makes sense. Venusaur. Now, Venusaur looks a lot more ferocious than the other two, but I don't dislike it. It's probably not one of my favourite final stages of starter Pokemon, but I don't mind it. I mean, I've used it on playthroughs before, and it's like with Bulbasaur, it's good for status conditions and also good for taking attacks, and it's pretty cool. Not my favorite, but I like it. Charmander. Now, Charmander is really cute. I think I like it more because of the anime and seeing what Ash's Charmander went through. It's really adorable. Charmeleon, I don't like as much. I don't hate it, but I don't like it as much. I mean, I've always found it weird how the Charmander evolutionary line, like, Charmander's kind of orangey, like lighter orangey color, and Charizard is like is an orangey color as well, but Charmeleon is red, reddy color. It never made sense to me. But I don't dislike Charmeleon. It's okay. It's pretty cool. It's still pretty cool. Charizard is pretty awesome. I mean, to be fair, it does get a lot of special treatment. It gets like, it's got two Megas and Gigantamax form and everything. But I still really like it, and it's really fun to use. And its shiny is really cool. I mean, its Gen 2 shiny is pretty bad. It's pretty like Barney the Dinosaur, but its later shiny versions are really, really cool. I mean, the black colour just, it looks so awesome. It really does. It really is cool. Yeah, Charizard is pretty badass. Yeah, I also like Charizard because of Ash's Charizard in the anime and how awesome it was. It was so fun to watch it beating down Articuno in the Battle Frontier. That was awesome. And just seeing how its character developed throughout the series, like I said before, like starting off being very anxious little thing, to going into a teenage rebellious stage, to being like one of Ash's most loyal and powerful Pokemon. It was just so cool. Squirtle. Squirtle is really cute. I really like Squirtle. I love its design. And turtles are cool, you know? People love turtles. And I think Ash's Squirtle in the anime made me love it even more. Wartortle. I really like Wartortle. It's still pretty cute, like Squirtle. I mean, it tries to look a lot tougher. It tries to have a little bit more toughness about it, but I think it kind of looks... It still looks really, really cute, but which kind of doesn't fit with its anime voice, which is, like, considerably... I mean, it's the evolution of Squirtle, but it's kind of a bit too of a big jump with its voice. Like, Squirtle sounds like, Squirtle! And Wartortle's like, Wartortle! It's like, a bit deeper than that. It's a bit too deep. Maybe there should have been, like, a voice in between for that. But I really like Wartortle. I think it's really cute. Yeah. And Blastoise. I don't mind Blastoise. I mean, it's not my favourite Final Star, but it is pretty cool, and it's fun to use as well. Yeah. Caterpie. Now Caterpie is really cute. I think the anime had an influence on how I feel about Caterpie. It's a little cutie. Metapod. Metapod. Yeah. It's okay. I mean, it's just intended to be a middle stage that you have to get through in order to access the final stage, so it's okay. So, I mean, every time I look at it, I just think of the Metapod versus Metapod battle in the earlier, in the earlier series. Yeah. That was an interesting battle, to say the least. Moving on. Butterfree. Butterfree is so cute. I just love Butterfree so much. It's just so adorable and pretty, and oh, I love it. It's just so cute. I have used one on a playthrough before. It's not particularly that good, and it's not the best Pokemon, not gonna lie, but I loved using it. Like the Bulbasaur line, it has access to status conditions, which can come in handy when you're trying to defeat other Pokemon that are perhaps maybe physically stronger than you. So that comes in handy. Okay. Weedle's kind of cute. It's okay, it's alright. Weedle's kind of cute, kind of cool, but not particularly memorable for me, personally. Kakuna. You know, despite the fact me saying that Metapod was like, yeah, okay. I actually like Kakuna a bit better than Metapod. It is kind of cool. I do like its design a little bit better. It's a little bit more interesting. Beedrill. Now, Beedrill's alright. It's obviously based off a bee. It's kind of cool, but I'm not a fan of wasps or bees. Well, I know bees do good things for the earth. Beedrill is pretty cool. Pidgey is pretty cool and cute. I mean, you do get sick of seeing it in the wild, in the games, but a Pidgeotto. Yeah, I like Pidgeotto as well. It's pretty cool. I think some of the Pokemon that I like, some of them will be due to the fact that I've seen the anime and seen Ash use them. That's probably going to be a big factor in why I like them. And Pidgeot, oh, I love Pidgeot. I mean, I wish Pidgeot was stronger than it actually is, but Pidgeot just aesthetically looks really, really cool. And its mega form looks even cooler. And its ability, that ability that it gets with its mega evolution, No Guard. I mean, that is really good. I mean, a lot of Pokemon I wish had No Guard. But yeah, Rattata. Not too keen on the Rattata line. I do prefer Cantonian Rattata in comparison to rather than Alolan Rattata. It's kind of, the Alolan form looks like it's got a bit of a mustache, and it kind of looks a bit weird to me. Raticate, not my favourite Pokemon, not very keen on it. Dislike, I prefer its Cantonian form to its Alolan form, personally. Spearow, aesthetically I do prefer the Pidgey line, but it's alright. Kinda cool looking. Spearow, yeah, it's an okay design. Not one of my favourite Pokemon. Kinda cool, but not really my taste. Ekans. I probably like Ekans more than, like, if I hadn't seen the anime, I probably wouldn't think that much of Ekans or Arbok, but seeing Jesse's Arbok, which used to be in Ekans, it kind of, like, brings back memories, and it's just so sweet how close it was to her, and it's just so sad that she had to release it, but, you know, it happened. I do like the purple colour in Ekans, and I think it's kind of clever how Ekans is snake backwards. I mean, some people might call that lazy, but I think it's kind of clever. Like, that didn't come to me immediately. I mean, I'm not daft, but it didn't come to me immediately. One thing I find interesting about Arbok is that it has a different design to it based on whether it was caught in Hoenn or if it was caught in Kanto. That kind of, to me, foreshadowed regional variance. I mean, it's not quite regional variance, but it made me think about that when I first heard about it. I like Arbok's design. It's quite cool looking. Pikachu. Pikachu is cute. I mean, you do see it a bit too much, but it is pretty cute. Raichu. Now, unlike with Raticate and Rattata, I do actually prefer Alolan Raichu to Cantonian Raichu. I mean, Cantonian Raichu is pretty cool, but I like Alolan Raichu more because I think it's a lot cuter, and I like the thing about it, liking pancakes. I'd get along with one, because I like me pancakes. But Cantonian Raichu is cool as well. Sandshrew. Sandshrew is pretty cute, with its big blue eyes, its little cute chunky body.
This is my other Sandshrew. And this is shiny.
Sandslash is pretty cool as well. Do you like the fact it's I do like now that it looks like it can, like, dig more effectively with its spikes on its back and its longer claws. That's pretty cool. I like how the spikes kind of stick out. I mean, they could have picked any colour for the spikes, but they picked like a nice brown colour, and that's cool. Nidoran line. Nidoran. Yeah. Now, Nidoran, male and female, they're pretty cute. Nice colours. Nidorina is pretty cool, and still kind of cute while looking ferocious at the same time. Nidoqueen. I really like Nidoqueen. I think maybe because I've used her in playthroughs before. I think I used her the first time in Heart Gold and Soul Silver. And she was really good in that. And I think I used her in Let's Go Eevee. And she was really good in that as well. Nidorino. Nidorino's alright. Pretty cool. I prefer Nidorina, but it might just be me. Nidoking is quite cool. It's got a really cool shiny as well, but Nidoking's shiny is like similar to Nidoqueen's colours. But I kind of wish that with Nidoqueen they kind of made its shiny like be Nidoking's colours. But yeah, I mean, with Nidoran female and Nidorina, they're like the same colours as the male versions. It makes no sense why they changed the colour on Nidoqueen. It's weird to me. It's like the Nidoran lines are cool. I like Nidoran lines. They're for thieves. It's also convenient how you can get a Moonstone very, very early on in Fire Red and Leaf Green. That really helps. I mean, the only thing is, like, you've got to be careful when you use it, because you don't want to miss out on any good moves, and they can get pretty good moves. Now, speaking of Moonstone and Pokemon that evolve via Moonstone, we're on to Clefairy now. Clefairy is really cute. It's pink and cute. Clefable is also very cute. It can be annoying to battle against nowadays that it's got the fairy type, and it's got Magic Guard, and that means that you can't use status conditions on it. Clefable is really cute as well. Good that they've both got the fairy typing now. Vulpix. I think Vulpix is really, really cute. I love both its Cantonian and Alolan forms. The same goes for Ninetales. Like I said, I love Alolan and Cantonian versions of Ninetales. When I was playing Let's Go Eevee, I used both a Cantonian and a Alolan Ninetales on the same team, and it was really interesting because, like, the same breed but different types. I think Ninetales in general, well, both versions of Ninetales are beautiful, elegant looking Pokemon. I think another reason why I love Ninetales is because it makes me think of Kuruma, like the Ninetales in Naruto. Except obviously it's spelled differently. Ninetales is, in Pokemon, is spelled like tales, as in folklore, as in stories, whereas Naruto's Ninetales are spelled like, because it has nine tails. Physical tails. Yeah. I always found that interesting. Yeah, Jigglypuff. Jigglypuff is really cute. I even have a charm of Jigglypuff that I have attached to one of my DS cases. I apparently it used to make a noise, but it doesn't anymore, but I still, like, really treasure it. I just love its, like, big eyes and this little cute little face. It's so adorable. Wigglytuff is also really cute. Maybe not as cute as Jigglypuff, but it's kind of cute. I still find it weird how Harley had a Wigglytuff on his team. I know it was like meant to look menacing and stuff, but it's just, it doesn't really match his style. But, meh. But yeah, Wigglytuff and Jigglypuff are both very cute. Zubat. Kind of like Zubat's design, but it's very annoying in games. Like, especially if you're underleveled and you just want to get through the cave and you don't have repels on you. You just want to get through the cave and you just keep getting hit by supersonic and leech life and you're like... Yeah. So that's alright. Golbat. I don't particularly like Golbat. Again, it can be kind of annoying to get past, like, later on in the game. Because they're kind of like Zubat, but worse. Obviously because the evolved form, but... Yeah, I've also never kind of been that keen on its design. I don't know. Also, one of its Gen 1 sprites really doesn't help it out in that regard. It's just... it's really funny, but awful. Yeah, in my opinion. It's like that. Yeah, a lot of the Gen 1 sprites were questionable, yeah. But, you know, you've got to start somewhere, you've got to learn. Oddish. I want Oddish. Oddish! Yes, I want Oddish. Oddish is kind of cute, kind of boring, but kind of cute. Gloom. It's kind of gross. I'm not very keen on Gloom. Yeah, I don't like in how some of the sprites it has saliva coming from its mouth. It's kind of a bit... it's not... not great. I don't hate it, but... not really my taste. Vileplume's kind of cute. I like the big flower it has on its head. Paris is, it's kind of cool. I mean, it's cool until you hear that, when it evolves into Parasect, it becomes a zombie, basically. Yeah. The mushrooms, take up the mushrooms, like, it gets a mushroom that, like, takes over its, body and controls everything, so it's kind of sad. Yeah, but Paris is kind of cute, but it's not... Paris is, it's okay. And Parasect's design is kind of cool until you know the background behind it. Until you know, what happens to it when it evolves from Paris. Yeah. Venonat. Venonat's okay. It's not really my taste. Venomoth. I kind of like Venomat more, but... It's okay. Diglett. I mean, it's supposed to be like a mole. I mean, it's kind of cute, but kind of weird. Dugtrio is even more weird. I mean, I have used Dugtrio on a playthrough before because I wanted to see what it was like, and it's incredibly slow and terrible at taking attacks. I mean, it can deal out decent attacks, but And it's a little informed. It's worse, in my opinion, it's worse than the Cantonian form. I mean, I don't get why adding hair to... I don't get why adding hair to it makes it have volcanic ash on it. That's apparently why it's got hair. It's kind of funny though. Now Meowth. Meowth is kind of cool. I probably like it more because of the anime. Meowth is, Meowth's pretty cool. I also like it in Persian's move Payday, which is so useful if you're like trying to grind and need money. You can just use it and then you get more money once the battle's over. And if you like use an amulet coin on your Pokemon for luck incense and you use Payday, you'll be quids in. Persian I'm not that keen on, but that's just me. But I mean, I like its Cantonian form more than its Alolan form. Same goes for Meowth. Psyduck. Psyduck's kind of cute. Probably like it a little bit more because of the anime. It's okay. And Golduck's okay. Just the only thing about those two is they both should be psychic type, but they're not. It doesn't make sense for them to be able to learn lots of psychic moves and Psyduck to have Psy at the beginning of its name, not for them to be psychic type. But yeah, they're not badly designed Pokemon. They're okay. Mankey. It's alright. Primeape is alright. I've used Primeape in playthroughs before. And it was kind of fun to use. I think I like Primeape more because of the anime and Ash's Primeape. I kind of wish it was like in the anime for longer. Growlithe. Growlithe's kind of cute and cool looking. And Arcanine is pretty awesome looking. I love its colour scheme and patterns on its body and everything. It's really cool. Poliwag is adorable. Really like Poliwag. Poliwhirl is it's alright. Poliwhirl's alright. Poliwrath, I mean it just looks like an angrier Poliwhirl. And I prefer Politoed over Poliwrath. Poliwrath's alright. I do prefer Politoed to it, but Abra's kinda like Abra's pretty cool. Only thing about it that irritates me is the fact that if you fail to catch it, it just runs away. But yeah, I like Abra's design. It's pretty cool. Kadabra. Kadabra's okay. Alakazam is pretty awesome. Kind of weird looking, but kind of awesome at the same time, if that makes sense. I've used an Alakazam more than once on playthroughs, and it was kind of fun to use. I even tried using its mega form as well. Machop it's okay. It's a bit weird looking in my opinion, but it's just my opinion. Kind of somewhat cute, but kind of cool, but and kind of weird looking basically, but okay. Machoke is alright. Kind of cool, but kind of weird looking. Machamp is even more weird looking, but kind of cool. Bellsprout is kind of weird, but I kind of like it. Weeping Bell is alright. It's kind of cool. Victory Bell, really weird, but I kind of like it. It's kind of hard to explain why. I used a Victory Bell in either Fire Red or Leaf Green, I can't remember. And it was quite fun to use. Tentacool, it's okay. It's a bit weird for me. Tentacruel, quite intimidating, which it's supposed to be, but kind of weird for me. Geodude is okay. Graveler, it's okay. I do prefer the Kantonian forms of the Geodude line to the Alolan forms. I think the Alolan forms look a bit weird, in my opinion. And Golem is, it's kind of cool, but it kind of doesn't make sense how it evolves from Graveler, and it looks quite a bit different from the other two. And Ponyta is really cute. I love Ponyta. I love the Galarian and Kantonian forms of Ponyta. Both very, very cute. And I have to say, Ponyta and Rapidash's shiny forms are really cute and cool too. Yeah, I love the blue flames on Kantonian Ponyta and the purpley flames on Rapidash. I think they look really, really cool. I really like Rapidash as well. It looks really cool and kind of pretty at the same time. Slowpoke is, well, very derpy, but kind of lovable at the same time. I kind of like it, but I kind of think it's really weird as well, if that makes sense. Slowbro, again, does look incredibly weird, but is also kind of cute. Magnemite, kind of cute. Cool, I like it. Magneton is very interesting concept. I like Magnemite more, but Magneton, I don't dislike Magneton. Farfetch'd is just, I've always found Farfetch'd's design a bit opposite of Farfetch'd, a bit not very standouty for me, but I don't dislike it. It's kind of a bit unusual, a bit weird. I kind of like Farfetch'd, but it's not really, but it's not one of my favourite. Dodoro, yeah, it's kind of weird, but it's kind of weird, as is Dodrio, but I think I like Dodoro more. Yeah, it's just weird. It's just the heads thing is a bit odd for me. Seal, it's like, I've heard a lot of people complain about Seal's name being unimaginative, and well, they're not wrong, it's not very imaginative. all they've done is just change a letter in its name, but I do kind of like Seal. It's got kind of got this cute derpy look to it, but it's like, but I still really kind of like it. Dewgong, that's a bit of a lazy name for a Pokemon, considering Dewgong as a species do actually exist. But I do actually really like Dewgong. I don't know, it still has a bit of a derpy look to it, but it's kind of cool as well. Also, I mean, it's not very good, but I enjoyed, like, I've used it in a playthrough, and it was fun to use. Grimer, I'm not too keen on the Grimer line. I'm not too keen on Grimer, and I'm not too keen on Muk, though Ash's Muk did make me like it a little bit more with how affectionate it is. I feel the same about its Alolan forms as well. Shellder, it's okay. Kind of weird, it's okay. Cloyster, it's alright. Ghastly, it's different. I kind of like it. Haunter, it's alright. Gengar is pretty scary looking, but really cool at the same time. And I've used Gengar on playthroughs in the past, and it was very fun to use, putting enemies to sleep and all that. Yeah, I think it's cool Ash has a Gengar now. I never imagined him getting a Gengar. I just didn't think it was the kind of Pokemon he'd have, but I mean, you wouldn't imagine him having a Muk, would you, really? But there we go. Onix. is alright. Not my favourite Pokemon, but it's okay. I mean, Groxonix probably made me like it more. Drowsy. Yeah, I think Drowsy looks really kind of creepy. And the same goes for Hypno. I think it's really creepy as well. The cries certainly don't help. Like, Krabby. Yeah, Krabby is kind of cool and cute. I like Krabby. And Kingler is pretty cool. Scary, but cool. I think Ash's Kingler made me like it a bit more. I wish we'd seen Ash's Kingler a bit more in the anime. It's a shame we don't get to see it much. But yeah, I like Kingler and Krabby's designs a lot. It's a shame Kingler isn't faster, you know, because I mean, I was using one in Let's Go Eevee, and it was so incredibly slow, and it kept getting hit, and the second hit always took it out. Oh, it was so frustrating, and this was when it was a high level as well, but maybe I used a bad-natured one, I don't know. I'm not that au fait with natures with Pokemon, but yeah. Voltorb. Voltorb's pretty cool. And Electrode is also pretty cool, and I like how their shinies are like based off Great Balls. Like, they're both, like, where it's red on the bodies, it's like a blue colour. I think that's really cool. Execute, very weird, but but different. Yeah. Executor, very weird again. Cubone. Cubone is adorable. Cubone's very cute. Marowak is very, very cool. Hitmonlee. Yes, Hitmonlee is kind of weird looking, but kind of cool at the same time. Hitmonchan is a bit cooler. I like its design. Lickitung, it's okay. It just, yeah. Koffing is kind of cute, kind of cool. I don't know, I feel that like it looks really happy when it's a Koffing, but when it becomes a Weezing, it's kind of a bit sad. I don't hate Weezing, but it just looks perpetually sad. But I mean, it might not be sad all the time. But yeah, I like coughing and don't like wheezing as much, but that's just my opinion. Rhyhorn. Rhyhorn's pretty cool, it's alright. Rhydon, a bit cooler, kind of like it. Not one of my favourites, but I like it. Chansey's alright. Tangela is kind of cute. Kind of cool. Yeah. Kangaskhan. Kind of like it. Like, looks ferocious, but it's kind of sweet how it's like a mother and baby Pokemon. Apparently Mega Kangaskhan is supposed to be really, really strong. I haven't really used it, but I might have a go at using it at some point. Horsey is adorable. I love Horsey. Seedra looks very terrifying, but it's okay. I'm using one at the moment on either Fire Red or Leaf Green. I'm hoping once I've beaten the league and the whole Sevii Islands bit that I'm hoping to evolve it into Kingdra. Goldeen is kind of pretty, but yeah, it's kind of pretty, Goldeen. Seaking is okay. It's okay. Staryu is pretty cool and cute. Starmie, I think I like Staryu more than Starmie, but Starmie is still kind of pretty. Mr. Mime, I think I share a very common opinion about Mr. Mime. It's kind of creepy. Scyther is pretty cool. I've never really used one, but it's pretty cool. Jinx... yeah. I'm not keen on Jinx. It's just... disturbing looking. Electabuzz is pretty cool. Probably like it more because Paul had an Electabuzz. And I really like Paul as a character. I don't usually like the characters who are a bit nasty. But, I don't know. Paul and Ash's rivalry was really, really entertaining to watch. I just love the lightning bolt designs on Electabuzz. Just shows it's an electric type. Makes it look very, very cool. Magmar. Magmar's alright. Yeah, again, probably like it more because of Paul. Magmar's cool. Kind of weird looking, but cool. Pinsir. It's alright. Kind of cool, but kind of terrifying. Tauros. Looks quite cool, yeah, I probably like it more because of Ash's Tauros in the anime. Magikarp, it's a Magikarp, it's okay. Gyarados is pretty cool, I like its shiny form, mainly because it's easy to get. No. I like its shiny form. It's definitely makes it stand out. Lapras. Lapras is a beautiful Pokemon. I love Lapras. Just, it would just be amazing to have your own Lapras just like ride on its back and go all over the world. That would be so cool. I mean, I've seen like inflatable Lapras things online that cost lots of money, but would be awesome to own one of those. It's just, it's gorgeous. And Perish Song comes in handy when you're struggling to take down an opponent, and I mean, it's not as strong as I'd like it to be, but it is, but it's just, it's awesome. I just love Lapras. I've used it on playthroughs before and it was fun to use. Ditto. Ditto was very cute. Good, it's good for breeding. That's all I'm gonna say. Yeah. Eevee. Eevee is adorable. I love Eevee so much. I have my own. Yes, I just adore Eevee. It's just so cute and lovely. So adorable. And its cry as well, it's like, Yippee! Yes. If like you could have a Pokemon in real life, I bet like Eevee would be a great one to have. Plus all of the possible things it can evolve into. You have so many choices as to what you can evolve into as well. I just love that gimmick about it, that you can evolve it into lots of different Pokemon. I mean, just makes such a change that you have choices. I mean, in Digimon you can digivolve things into lots of different things, but in Pokemon you always have such a straight line. But with Eevee it's just completely different. That's what makes it so cool. But as well as it being absolutely adorable as well. Yes. Vaporeon, it's pretty cool. It's okay. Vaporeon's pretty cool. Jolteon is pretty cool. I think I've used Jolteon on a team before. I think I used it on Heart Gold or Soul Silver. It was fun to use. Flareon, yeah, I've definitely used Flareon before. Flareon is probably my favourite out of the three original evolutions, because it's so cute. It's probably the weaker of the three, but I still love it. Porygon. Porygon is pretty cool. I like Porygon. Omanyte. Lord Helix. Worship Lord Helix. Okay. Yeah, Omanyte's pretty cute. Lord Helix. Anyway. Yes, Omanyte is pretty cute. Interesting fact about Omanyte. It has the same cry as Machop. Machop. Did I even say that right? I don't know. There's inconsistent pronunciations of Pokemon names throughout Pokemon, so I could be saying it wrong. yes. Omastar. Terrifying. but it's okay. Kinda cool, but I think Omanyte, I like Omanyte more. Kabuto. You know, when I read Kabuto, I just think about Kabuto and Naruto. Or is it pronounced Kabuto? I don't know. Anyway, it's alright. I do prefer Omanyte's design, though. Might just be me. But, Kabutops, yeah, I think that's right. Yeah, I prefer Kabutops' design to Omastar's. I think it looks cooler, and Aerodactyl is pretty cool. Snorlax, pretty classic Pokemon. It's kind of cool. I mean, I probably like it more because of the anime and the fact I've actually used it on playthroughs, and it's kind of fun to use. Yeah, it's a very strong and bulky Pokemon, and I enjoyed using it, and I like it. Articuno. Now, Articuno is probably my favourite out of the three legendary birds. I mean, it has loads of weaknesses, being ice flying, but it's just, its design is just beautiful. I just love it so much. Zapdos. Now, Zapdos is pretty cool. I'm using one on my Fire Red or Leaf Green team at the moment, and it's quite fun to use. I keep forgetting it's weak to ice. it's pretty cool in design. It definitely shows that it's an electric type, in how its body just spikes out like that, and it's all yellowy and black, and it's like electricity. It's so cool. But Articuno is still my favourite. Now Moltres. Moltres. It's pronounced Moltres, isn't it? I keep pronouncing it Moltres. But, yeah. Moltres is pretty cool, pretty awesome. I really like its design. Dratini is absolutely adorable. I love Dratini so much. It is so adorably cute. Dragonair is beautiful as well. I just love it. It's just so elegant, and oh, I love it. So pretty. Dragonite. Now, a lot of people complain that the transition from Dratini and Dragonair to Dragonite is kind of weird. And yeah, it is. But I kind of like Dragonite. It's a bit derpy, but I love it. It's just so, it's adorable but strong. Yeah, it doesn't make sense with how the evolution line works, kind of like Golem with Graveler and Geodude, but I still like Dragonite. I don't like Dragonite shiny though, but I love Dragonite otherwise. Ash's Dragonite has made me love Dragonite even more, because Ash's Dragonite is just a cinnamon roll. It is just the most sweetest thing ever. It just hugs anybody it meets, and it's just so sweet. I've used it in Soul Silver and in Leaf Green or Fire Red, one of those. And it's fun to use. I mean, you've got more variety in Soul Silver with what moves you can teach it, but it's still fun in the Kanto games as well. It's good. Mewtwo. Now, I think Mewtwo is really, really cool. Like, the first Pokemon movie made me like it even more. Like, hearing its backstory and it commanding all those Pokemon and battling against Mew. Oh, that was awesome. And it's super strong. I like how it made, I don't know whether you guys know this, but it made a return in Pokemon Journeys. Absolutely decimated Ash and Go, but you know, it was nice to see it again. And Mew is absolutely adorable. I just love it. It's just so cute with its big eyes and Mew, you know. It's just, oh, it's so cute. I only wish it was easier to obtain in the games. So yeah, like Mew. So yeah, so there's my opinions on all 151 of the original Pokemon in the original Kanto Dex. So next time we'll be talking about all the Johto Pokemon and all my opinions on them. Please take note that all of these are my opinions. If you don't agree with them, that's absolutely fine. Everybody is entitled to their own opinion, and I'll see you in the next video.